At last I found a small tree that I thought bore the same fruit as that I had eaten. The berry was dark purple instead of light lavender, but otherwise it was quite similar. Being unable to climb the tree, I was obliged to wait underneath it until a sharp breeze arose and shook the limbs so that a berry fell. Instantly I seized it, and taking a last view of the world, as I then thought, I ate the berry in a twinkling. Then, to my surprise, I began to grow big again until I became my former stature, and so I have remained. Needless to say, I have never eaten again of the lavender fruit, nor do any of the beasts or birds that live upon this island eat it. They had all three listened eagerly to this amazing tale, and when it was finished, the Ork exclaimed,
"Do you think, then, that the deep purple berry is the antidote for the lavender one?"
"I'm sure of it," answered Pessim.
"Then lead me to the tree at once," begged the Ork, "for this tiny form I now have terrifies me greatly."
Pessim examined the Ork closely. "You are ugly enough as you are," said he. "Were you any larger, you might be dangerous."
"Oh, no," Trot assured him. "The Ork has been our good friend. Please take us to the tree."
The Pessim consented, although rather reluctantly. He led them to the right, which was the east side of the island, and in a few minutes brought them near to the edge of the grove which faced the shore of the ocean. Here stood a small tree bearing berries of a deep purple color. The fruit looked very enticing, and Cap'n Bill reached up and selected one that seemed especially plump and ripe. The Ork had remained perched upon Trot's shoulder, but now it flew down to the ground. It was so difficult for Cap'n Bill to kneel down with his wooden leg that the little girl took the berry from him and held it close to the Ork's head.
"It's too big to go into my mouth,"
said the little creature, looking at the fruit sidewise.
"You'll have to make several mouthfuls of it, I guess," said Trot, and that is what the Ork did.
He pecked at the soft, ripe fruit with his bill and ate it up very quickly because it was good. Even before he had finished the berry, they could see the Ork begin to grow. In a few minutes he had regained his natural size and was strutting before them, quite delighted with his transformation.
"Well, well, what do you think of me now?" he asked proudly.
"You are very skinny and remarkably ugly," declared Pessim.
"You are a poor judge of Orks," was the reply. "Anyone can see that I'm much handsomer than those dreadful things called birds, which are all fluff and feathers."
"Their feathers make soft beds," asserted Pessim.
"And my skin would make excellent drumheads," retorted the Ork. "Nevertheless, a plucked bird or a skinned Ork would be of no value to himself, so we needn't brag of our usefulness after we are dead. But for the sake of argument, friend Pessim, I'd like to know what good you would be were you not alive?"
"Never mind that," said Cap'n Bill. "He isn't much good as he is."